Yeah. He is the go-to veterinarian for celebrities like actress Drea De Mateo, Kelly Hu, Lori Loughlin, and Emmy Rossum. And today he is joining me in studio. Welcome, celebrity veterinarian Dr. Jeff Werber. Thank you for being here. We just realized that there's a big vet convention in town, and you are a part of it. And my daughter's playing volleyball at the same place. So there's vets and volleyballers all over the place.
That's great.
You have such an interesting take on pets and giving them the love, because there's a lot of things that can be transmitted from owner to pet that we didn't realize.
Right, it can happen. You know, we call it zoonotic diseases. And, you know, things like parasites. There was a story about a hedgehog that gave somebody salmonella.
Yes, I saw that.
And it can happen. You know, it's a matter of being careful. There are internal parasites like roundworms and hookworms can actually cause problems in people. And then other internal parasites that like toxoplasmosis and salmonella, we just talked about the hedgehog, capnocytophaga. Now that's the one, if you heard months ago about a guy who was licked in the face by his dog and had to have his arms and legs amputated. Those are very, very, very rare conditions. And that he was some immunosuppressed. If a person's on immunosuppressive medicine or himself has a condition that cause immunosuppression, of course, it's a matter of just taking it easy. Fleas and ticks. Ticks carry a lot of diseases. Rocky Mountain spotted fever and ehrlichiosis and things like that. So again, we want to be careful about the other internal parasites as well.
And then, so the internal ones versus the external
ones. External ones, things like ringworm.
Okay.
That's an external parasite.
And how can you get that from?
Scabies. People can get scabies from their dog.
From their dog?
But the good news is that it's self-limiting in people.
Okay, good.
So, the keys really are transmission either is from fecal-oral, it's meaning contamination, undercooked foods, not washing vegetables, doing gardening. Pregnant women and toxoplasmosis is really a bad combination. So if you are a pregnant woman and you like to garden, make sure you wear gloves. Make sure you don't clean the litter box.
It's just common sense, really,
making sure
you keep your hands
clean.
Absolutely,
it's totally common sense.
What are some of the symptoms we need to look out
symptoms,
for?
Symptoms, depending on what it is, scratching, if it's skin, a bite wound, obviously you can get infected. The lethargy, weight loss, fever, it's basic stuff. And, allergies, so if you're doing a lot of sneezing and upper respiratory, chances are you may be allergic to one of the pets around the house. I used to be allergic to everything.
And look at what you do.
And I'm a veterinarian.
All right, so what about treatments?
So treatment is all depends on specifically what it is. So it's using caution, exercising caution. If it's a bite wound, if it's a rash, then make sure to go ahead and wash it well. And if it's something that's bad, it's something that's not getting better on its own, seek medical attention. It's very important to seek medical attention in a case like that, especially when it comes to certain bite wounds. Cat scratch fever, it's Bartonellosis. Those, it's rare, but your lymph nodes swell up. And I remember some of my vet school classmates getting and thinking,
oh my God, I have
cancer.
It makes common sense. Keep your hands clean. Don't worry about that. And still love your pet.
It's okay if they lick you, my bones. I get more tongue than anybody I know. So it's okay.
Thank you so much. It's so great talking to you. Send it over to you, Courtney.